After learning about irrigation, now let us know the traditional methods of irrigation. So there are mainly so four traditional methods were followed. So the one is the moat or the pulley system. The second one is the chain pump. Third one is Degri and fourth one is Rahat. So which uses a rubber system. So all these are some of the traditional methods of irrigation. Here pumps are commonly used for lifting water, diesel, biogas, electricity and solar energy is used for running these pumps. So now let us understand the modern methods of irrigation. So one is sprinkler system. So what is this sprinkler system? So this sprinkler system is useful on uneven land where sufficient water is not available. So you might have seen this. So here in the sprinkler system, the water escapes from the nozzles and it appears as though it rains, as though it appears like raining. Water escapes from the rotating nozzles and it keeps on rotating. So where the water is sprayed to far places. So at regular distances, these sprinklers are kept in a field. So it covers the whole field. So thus water is available for each and every time. And this method is useful for lawns, coffee plantation and also several other crops. So next is the second type. It is drip system. As the name itself says, in this system the water falls drop by drop directly near the roots. So as the name indicates, drip irrigation, so water falls drop by drop directly near the roots of the plants. So this system is called as drip irrigation or drip system. Drip irrigation or drip system. And it is best for watering the fruit plants, gardens and trees. So now after learning the traditional and the modern methods of irrigation, so now we have to understand or we have to learn how to protect the crops from weeds. How to protect the crops from weeds, protection from weeds. First, what are weeds? Weeds are the unwanted plants or undesirable plants that grows along with the main crop. Weeds are the undesirable plants, so these grows naturally along with the main crop. So that is called as weeds. So these weeds are also the plants. So these weeds has to be removed. If the weeds are not removed, it competes for water, nutrients, space and light with the other crop plants. So and it affects the growth of the crop. So thus the growth of the crop is affected. So these weeds has to be removed. The process of removal of weeds is called as weeding. So several methods were followed by the farmers to remove the weeds. Some farmer use the chemical and some farmer use the sickle to cut the weeds. So now what are weedicides? Weedicides are the chemicals used by the farmers to control the growth of the weeds. So example 2,4-D. So 2,4-D is a chemical which is used to control the weeds. It kills the weeds. So after controlling the weeds, so the plant grows healthily. So when the plant gets mature, so we need to harvest the crops. So this is one of the main part in the field of agriculture, harvesting. So what is harvesting? So it is just the process of cutting the crop after it is mature. After the plant is mature, the cutting of the crop is called as harvesting. So there are different methods are followed to separate. So one is threshing. So here the grain seeds are separated from the chaff. The grain seeds are separated from the chaff. Chaff is the plant. So where the grain seeds are removed from the main plant. So that process is called as threshing. So threshing is done with the help of machines nowadays, and still traditional methods are also. Threshing is carried out with the help of a machine called combine, which is in fact a harvester as well as a thresher. So we know what is a harvester and what is harvesting and a threshing. So both are done, so the name combine. So now the next process is winnowing. So winnowing, so it is also a method of separating grain from the chaff. So here with the help of air is done. Usually the farmers stand at some height and they drop the grains with slightly moving, so that heavy grain particles will fall down, while the lighter particles like chaff, leaves, dust, everything will carry it away by the air. So this is also one of the method called as winnowing. So after separating the grain, so the one of the most important task comes, so that is the storage. So these harvested grains has to be stored properly, otherwise it may get spoiled. If freshly harvested grains are stored without drying, the freshly harvested grains contains lot of moisture in it, so which may get spoiled easily or even attacked by the organism, and it becomes unfit for human use or even for germination. And before storing these grains, it should be dried properly in the presence of sunlight, and which helps to prevent the attack from insect, pests, bacteria and fungi. So if the grains are dried properly, so in the sunlight, then it prevents the attack of these insect, pests and bacteria. So the moistureness in the grains will help in attacking of the insect. So if moisture is removed, so the grains can be protected. So farmers store grains usually in the jute bags. And if large scale, if there is a large amount of grains, so it is done, the storage is done in silos and granaries to protect from pests like rats and insects. When there is a large storage of grains. So it is done in the silos and granaries, so that protects from the rats and insects. So sometimes in our homes, dried neem leaves are kept to protect from the insects, rats, and mold. For large quantities of grains in big godowns, specific chemical treatments are required. So at home we can use a natural disinfectant like neem leaves. But when you store in big godowns, so some chemical treatments are required. These are some of the storage techniques so that each and every farmer has to follow. Now, food from animals. So we get food not only from plants. So animals are the indirect source of our food. So we get milk, egg, meat, wool, honey, etc. from the animals. So animals are raised even at home or in farms. And if animals are taken care properly, so then the animals will grow healthily. So we get a large quantity of milk, egg, meat, etc. So the practice of food, providing food, shelter, and taking care of animals. So the proper practice of providing food, shelter, and taking care of animals is collectively called as animal husbandry.